So now I want to talk a little bit about sessions without cookies. Sessions without cookies is kind of an advanced topic. The only reason I kind of like to talk about it at this point is if you've been using my auto graders, you've been seeing sessions without cookies, and you've been seeing that cookie-less sessions, you've been using them, and so you're like, scratch, 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 I'm using the auto grader, but it's not setting a cookie. If you have a simple full screen application that's got a web page and you go and you log in and you log out and all that stuff and shopping cart, normal cookie-based sessions work great because if you have the whole page, one site, that you can set cookies. But increasingly, browsers are not letting you set cookies in situations where you might be functioning in an iframe. Or if you want to open an application in multiple tabs and log in on different accounts in the different tabs, that doesn't work very well with a global session cookie. On an incognito browser, if you open an incognito browser, they get a different copy. Each one gets a different copy of the cookies. So you can log in as two people. Multiple tabs, you can't log in as two people, but incognito browsers, you can log in as two people. And so there are times that it's good for you to not use session cookies. And increasingly, as applications move from running in the server to running in the client, they tend to use cookies less and less, and they use like tokens and stuff like that. And so it turns out that PHP has probably the nicest support of any programming language, any web programming language, any web framework that I've ever seen for maintaining sessions without cookies. And they're a little weird because you have to still create this mark on each browser and then get the mark back and reassociate. And so the way this tends to work is you set them either in form requests or anchor tags, okay? And so here's a bit of code that we can play with and just take a look at how this works. Let's go to nocookie.php. There's no cookie. We've got a session ID, and the best way to look at this is to view the source of it and see what's going on here. And so what's happening is if I click on this href, you'll see I've got a get parameter, which is PHP sesh ID. So the whole idea of a session is it's got to be the same from request to request. Okay, and so if I click on that, you'll see how it reassociates with the same cookie. And also if I click on a form, I've got this input, a hidden tag, that is the key of PHP session ID and the value of the session, okay? And so regardless of what I click on this anchor tag, so look at that right there, see the PHP session ID there is, and I'm still adding one to the session and it's working, and so there are no cookies in this session, and I can also send the form, and if I send the form, it still knows because the form is sending this hidden value because hidden values are like text except you're not seeing it, right? So it's right here. There's a hidden text field, but it's not showing. And so this way I can implement this little cookie, this little thing that updates the session 0, 1, 2, and then 3 resets it, the same thing, right? I can do this either with anchor tags or with form tags, and PHP actually has added all this stuff automatically, and this is what I didn't mean to click there. This is what I like about PHP. If I tell it I'm going to not use cookies, then it does its best to maintain them, okay? It alters, you look at the source code, and you'll see I didn't put this on here, and I did not put that input tag. So when we take a look at source code, you'll see that. So that's how it works. It's cookie-less, and that's why if you're running my auto graders, you keep seeing this. Now, my auto grader, go ahead and try to break in. I probably shouldn't say that, but my auto grader protects itself in different ways by checking the IP address that it comes from and the browser that it's coming from, and so it's a little harder to break in. If you do sessionless cookie-less sessions and you don't protect yourself otherwise, you're actually kind of opening yourself up for a world of hurt, and that's why I wrote a whole bunch of code, and that's why I encourage people to use frameworks rather than just roll their own. But okay, enough of that. This Sugi stuff that I've written is designed to run with multiple sessions in multiple tabs, work in iframes, et cetera, which are the challenges of cookie-based sessions. That's where cookie-based sessions are challenging. Okay, and so here's the code. And this is kind of advanced. I'm not really telling you that you're supposed to know every bit of this stuff. But basically, there's some settings that you set to say, hey, don't use cookies. Don't only use cookies, and whatever this is, you can go Google Stack Overflow and you say, how do I not use cookies in PHP? And they're like, put these three things in there. So you put these three things in there. And after you do that, these things are informing session start to use cookie-less sessions, which means they're not going to, session start at this point is not going to try to set a cookie, and it's not going to look at any cookie. It's going to assume that the cookie detail is going to either be in $_get or $_post under the session ID, right? So if you saw those, it was PHP session ID equals as get or PHP session ID as post. And then from that point on, it's exactly the same code, right? You just use session. Cookieless sessions are no different except these three lines of code. And that's what I like about PHP and cookieless sessions. But don't overthink this. Just understand that it's possible. And in other programming languages and other web frameworks, it's possible. You just have to manually put it on all of the gets and all the posts. But PHP friendly, thank you, PHP does it for us automatically. I don't know why they decided to do such a nice thing, but it's turned out to be very, very useful to me because, like I said, I have applications that need to have different session information in different tabs. Now, my applications are not the same as your typical social media site, but I have reason for needing this. And so that the rest of that code is no particular thing. The session ID is the same. It's all the rest of that code is identical. You just say, hey, PHP, do this. Now, a couple of caveats. If you're doing things that we haven't done yet, like Ajax and JavaScript and things like that, or you're constructing URLs in the browser, you have to pass the session ID back to those folks. So if you're using those kinds of things, and if you are bookmarking a URL or emailing a URL, you might actually be logged in. Because you are inadvertently compromising your session. And I have built ways in applications that use cookieless sessions to have an additional layer of protection to make sure that the session ID is not the only thing that that we've got. Okay? So even though that summary bit of the sessionless cookies was kind of advanced, the basic idea of cookies and sessions and how to use sessions in PHP is really simple and ultimately very elegant. And up next, what we're going to talk about is how we use this session thing. So we're going to assume session, assume cookies, but then what do we do with it inside of our applications? So the applications of sessions is really the next topic.